was saying that you guys went through a pretty, I think you said, hefty film session on working on turnovers and things like that after the last game. How much of an emphasis has that been? You said that was one of the things you're concerned about.
Yeah, big emphasis. But you know, a lot of them we're seeing are almost unforced, and I don't want to say unforced, but just carelessness on our part. And we've got to do a better job catching and not dribbling. If there's three guys standing there, don't dribble there. You'll be ready to catch the basketball, those types of things. And, you know, a lot of new faces, so sometimes we're not connecting the dots just where we need to be yet.
And so I was wondering if some of that is just youth, if some of that's just, you know, guys, you know, figuring out who they are and who they are on the court together.
Yeah, I believe so. I really do. And but, you know, the ones that drive me insane is when the same thing happens twice. Mm-hmm. Then we're not paying attention and we're not thinking. Grambling was doing a couple things, and you know, some guys in the game that didn't see it. Mm-hmm. That's carelessness.
That two games in with all these new rule changes, Mark was saying he's still not sure what exactly all the changes are. Are there any that maybe you view as a bigger adjustment than maybe you had anticipated coming into the season?
No, I really haven't noticed. You know, there was a timeout taken the other day, and I think it was Mark says, "Hey, is this the media timeout?" I said, "I have no idea." So I'm still learning those as well, but I haven't seen anything that has really caught my attention in terms of I've had to alter the way I think or anything like that in the first two games.
I think KJ was just in here and said that film study is kind of a new thing to him. Yeah, with this young team, how do you see them reacting to that? How do they react to criticism maybe during film study? And are they seeing the value of it?
I think so. For a lot of, and it's funny because we tell them, there was a study done many years ago on a soccer team, and they hooked their brains up to electrodes or whatever, and when they'd see themselves make a mistake, that's all they would think about for the next 5 minutes, so they weren't watching the rest of the film. And so we always try to make our guys aware of that this is not a punishment. We're trying to make you better. And just some of the things I've noticed that I do terminology wise, I'm saying it and I'm like, well, I'm not sure he knows exactly what I'm, so it's probably been a little bit more elementary than it has been in the past.
Because we were talking to AJ for the first time, and we're still kind of getting a feel for his game. Is the game moving fast for him right now? Some of the mistakes that he's made and some of the just, I guess, general adjustments, but do you see the game being fast for him?
Yeah, but he plays fast. But I think it is, you know, the first pass he threw, I told him, I said, if that ball went into backwards, it'd still be going today. But I think that he's learning to his role right now on this team is he's coming off the bench, he's providing a spark. He probably thinks he has to play a little faster. I thought, quite honestly, I've seen drastic improvement from Walsh to Mount St. Mary's to Grambling the other night. So I think that's moving in a positive direction. You know, he's been thrust in a position that he's never been in before. Mm-hmm. In terms of coming on, I think he was a four-year starter at Dunbar.
Looking at like the numbers this year compared to last year, I know it's early to have really a big sample size, but like D'Angelo led you in turnovers at this point last year, and he was obviously a freshman. And so I wonder if that's just something, you know, when you're at least D'Angelo had some seniors around him last year.
Right.
You know, these guys don't have that cushion, I guess.
Right, right. Yeah, because the second game D'Angelo played at 7 mm-hmm. against Marquette. And, but yeah, there's going to be that kind of filling out process. But, you know, the ones that I always tell them I'm not going to ask you to play perfect, but we just got to clean up a couple of the minute ones that just can't happen.